In this video, I'm going to be sharing with you the third component to an effective offense in Madden 21, and that is the ability to have a constraint theory play. Now, what a constraint theory play is a constraint theory play is something that you can go to or something that you can call that is going to take advantage of when the defense starts to over-pursue, when they start to get too aggressive. This is something that you can go to, very simple, and the bunch tight end actually has several different variances for this. Now, if you're new to the channel and you don't know who I am, my name is Cody, and my channel is all about helping people become the best Madden player that they can possibly become. And so if you want to get better at this game, I just want to encourage you to click the subscribe button at the bottom right-hand corner of your screen. It's completely free to subscribe, and it just allows you to be able to stay up to date on the latest tips and strategies right here on the channel. Now, in this video, like I said, we're talking about the bunch tight end, and if you want to get my entire bunch tight end and trips tight end offset, so Jets ebook, you can get that in the description. The bunch tight end honestly doesn't really have to be ran with anything else. It can stand by itself. And so I've actually, in the guide, I've talked about how to use it, you know, in combination with the bunch, but I've also talked about how to use it as its standalone offensive scheme. And so if you want to get that, that link is in the description. I'm going to put it right down in there for you so that you can get access to that. But what we're talking about is, what do you do whenever your defense starts to get over aggressive? Maybe they're blitzing a lot, or maybe they are, maybe they're really, really over adjusting to a corner route or an adjustment or something like that. That's where this really, really comes in handy. So the play that we're going to be talking about in this video is the play mesh from the bunch tight end. It's a very, very underrated little passing concept and very effective. And basically what we're going to do is I'm just going to audible to it. And if you take a look at the adjustments here, essentially it's relatively simple. There's really nothing that's really that complex with this, but this is primarily for situations when you're facing a lot of Mabel coverage or zone drop coverage, where they're really paying very careful attention to the crossing route from the PA boot over and the corner route from tight end corner. This is really the perfect little concept that you can go to. There's also another play that I'm going to talk about in tomorrow's video about it, because I think that, you know, you can actually have two different constraint theory plays. This one in particular is really designed to help you beat Tampa 2 style coverages. I think Tampa 2 is underrated. I think you're going to see that, you know, if you run bunch tight end with any regularity, I think people will actually run a fair amount of Tampa 2 on you. So anyways, the adjustments are as follows. We're going to take the triangle receiver. We're going to put him on a streak. And then what we're going to do underneath here is we're actually going to essentially put the running back on a little smart routed option route, just like so. If you wanted to, you could put the tight end on a curl and put the running back on an in route. Those are all different options. You could also do it, you know, you could also do it just like this right here. You could put a delay drag out there. There's pretty much any, you know, possibilities are endless for this. My personal recommendation would be to put a smart routed option route and a delay drag on the field. But if you take a look at this corner route here to the square receiver, when we call this, you see that the cover two actually will do okay. As you see right there, I mean, it does okay. But the trick of it, the little trick of the trade when you want to call this, is what you want to do is you want to simply motion out the corner route. If you motion out the corner route, it makes it a little bit more effective and a little bit more successful. So if I go to the play, mesh right here, all I'm going to do is I'm going to streak the triangle receiver. I'm going to delay drag and smart routed option route there. And then I've got cover two here on the left side. But because it's such a deep Mabel, I can easily just get that ball to him. And of course, my gunslinger, you do need a gunslinger quarterback for this one. It's actually really important because of the window. It is a little bit of a tighter window to hit this in, but I just want you to see what I'm talking about first. So again, you're just getting this guy way out here, and basically what's going to happen is, you know, you're just going to hit him quick, right? It's very simple, but it's very, very effective. Now, if you want to do this another way, you actually can, and the way you can do that is through the play tight end corner. We talked a little bit about this play, but basically all you're going to do is you're just going to streak the X receiver. You're going to put the circle receiver on a smart route, and then you're just going to basically motion him to the right. And it's the same concept, right? Same exact concept. It's just it comes from the goes to the other side, which is, you know, another whole play entirely. But it's a very simple thing that you can do from mesh. Now, let's talk about man coverage just for a moment. This play is not the greatest against man coverage. If you see man coverage, I want to tell you, one thing you can do is just put circle on an out. If you put circle in a little five-yard out route, it actually does oftentimes beat man-to-man. You can put that circle receiver on a zig. You can put him on an out route. And really, it's not going to like hinder the play any. So another thing you can do, and this is actually really interesting. So another thing you can do if you wanted to is you could actually motion circle wherever you want to go, right? One thing that you can, I mean, you can do anything you want, but really what I like to do here, you could even do like a double drag. If you wanted to do a traditional mesh concept, you could do that, and they will beat man out of this formation very, very effectively, as you can see. Now, knowing ahead of time that most people like Mabel coverages, a lot of people really will. A lot of people will be Mabel coveraging. I'll guarantee you that. And so what you're going to see is, you know, what they might do is they might man him up, right? So if they man up that player, then what are you going to do? What is your next step, basically? So if we just run this play as is, like I was talking about, you're going to see you've got a couple of different options. The first thing that you can do is this triangle receiver. You see that that's not going to be cover three, but your running back's going to get wide open. Another thing that you can do, we talk a little bit about beating cover three. There's so many ways to beat cover three from this formation, so I'm not gonna spend too much time on that. I want to shift to man coverage for just a moment. So if they run man coverage, and if you are in a position where you don't really have a great man beater on the field, on the left side of the field, then, you know, what are you going to do? Well, basically, you first thing we'll look to that corner route, but the running back is going to be open. As you can see right there, gets wide open to the outside. He's matched up on a safety. That's going to be an easy read. The next thing that gets open really, really well against this kind of defense is a delay drag to the tight end. The delay drag to the tight end is super underrated. All you do is just release it. Once you see man coverage, just release it. He'll beat it. I mean, he'll literally beat it. Now, if you don't want, if you want to do the rollout glitch, you can. But normally the tight end, if you put him on a delay drag, he's gonna be, you know, getting very decent little separation. So again, you just motion out, and then you see right here. I mean, it's just easy separation. You know, and again, maybe I need a possession catch that, but that's, you know, a simple little option that you can have against that. As far as what defends this well, what can they do to defend this well? Well, really what they can do is if they just man up square. It's very unlikely that they're going to do that. Also, match coverage does okay. One little thing you can do, let me back out of here real quick. I want to talk about match coverage just for a second. Match coverage is probably the best counter to that specific play. The problem is match coverage doesn't do that great against everything else that you do from bunch tight end. It does okay against that specific play. That's why it's called a constraint theory play, because you're only going to call it if you know that you're anticipating that you're going to get that specific coverage. But let me just show you cover four quarters really quickly. So if I make sure that all the routes go vertical, I'm still going to have open routes. And if you just watch here, you see that this little option route still gets wide open against match coverage. That's the beauty of an option route, is it really does make it so that they have to run essentially a cover two to the running back side. That's kind of the key to stopping option routes, to basically have a vertical hook there, and then to also have like a hard flat on that same side, because you stop the quick flat and you stop the option route. But anyways, that is the constraint theory play from bunch tight end. It's called mesh. It's a very simple but very, very effective play. Be sure to add it to your playbook. And if you want to get my entire bunch tight end offensive guide, you can get that in the description of this video for just $15. It's probably, honestly, if I was being 100% transparent, it's probably the most consistent offense that I've had success with in this year's game. I continue to find myself going back to it because it is so simple. And it's one of those things where the offense really does work hand in hand together. Thanks for watching this video. And if you want to get the guide, it is in the description.